you're getting better all the time and turning all against one is an art that's hard to teach. Another clever word sets off an unsuspecting herd, and as you step back in the line, a mob jumps to their feet. Now dance, fucker, dance, man, he never had a chance. And no one even knew it was really only you. And now you steal away. Take him out today. Nice work, you did. You're gonna go fuck it. With a thousand eyes and a good disguise. Hit him right between the eyes. Hit him right between the eyes. When you walk away, nothing more to say. See the lightning in your eyes. See him running above their lives.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to TPGW Live. I'm mtbDAhkk, and oh no. God damn it, what's he want now?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the TPGW 239 champion from Aaron Wilkins and Rex Titus. Pantheon!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be getting started with our first match, which is the steel cage match between Duncan Vermil and Darren Payne. Right after this, apparently. Pantheon was not supposed to be here tonight. And I'm going to tap out until Rex is done running his mouth doing whatever he does. Because frankly, I do not have time for him tonight.
So here's the deal. Wait, Wilkins, where are we tonight?
Chicago, boss.
Oh, that's right. Chicago, the city of quitters.
Oh, shut the hell up. You know he's right. Jordan quit the Bulls twice and CM Punk quit for 7 years.
Just like MTB, who fits in quite well here. Quit on all of you twice, and when he gets called out on it, he calls in another quitter in Don Callis to screw over the only symbol of solidarity TPGW has left. But he forgot one thing. The pantheon of professional wrestling doesn't fall so easily.
Would you shut the hell up? You've been going on and on about how MTB's been screwing you, Rex. You're just salty because you knew Kenny Omega was coming and you couldn't stop it. You knew that you would get screwed in that match. But MTB still hold on here. In my opinion, that just means you suck.
You need to watch your mouth, boy. or the heretic will be the only nightmare you have to deal with.
I'm going to pretend you didn't just say that.
Enough. Aaron will handle Omega on the next Fury before I get him at Resurrection. But as for you, Schultz, I think I'll put you down myself in the arena.
Looking forward to it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here we go with our first match, and I finally got my commentary team here, Robert McNicol and Cody Williams.
Hello.
Yo. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, God. Blood Wolf.
This is a Revolution 5 rematch inside of a steel cage.
Oh, fuck.
That's lovely. What? Matches already terrify me, though.
Oh, we're gonna have two of the most badass motherfuckers in TPGW. We've already faced off once at Rev 5 with Duncan getting the W and keeping his undefeated streak running. And now they're gonna duke it out again inside of steel cage. Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Darren Payne made it clear he's not done with Duncan. Just because Duncan beat him at Revolution doesn't mean Darren Payne is willing to just lay down and die.
So basically, Darren Payne is for what a certain monster did in the Fed when a certain other dude said, I'm not finished with you!
Basically.
But more importantly, killing time!
Yeah, it is killing time, as here comes the former.
This is crazy.
And one Duncan Vermil.
Duncan Vermil, a two-time TPGW world champion.
Oh,
a two-time Euro-American champion. A Royal Rumble winner.
I'm surprised and shocked that this man hasn't decided to go after neither the Euro-American or the Triple Crown, or hell, even the tag team title, to make history on his own. But you know what? Like you always say, Duncan is Duncan.
Duncan does what Duncan wants, and right now Duncan wants to kill Darren Payne. Just murder
him.
Yeah,
much like
especially
Darren
Payne
wants to kill him.
Especially after Christmas in the Garden, where Darren Payne cost Duncan the world title.
Right? Yeah, Duncan was on the verge of becoming a three-time world champion, but Darren Payne decided to get in his head, which got him distracted long enough for Son Gohan to hit him with the Masenko and retain the world heavyweight title. And then after that, Payne decided to put his 2 cents in and tell him, I'm not done with you, not by a mile. Heads up.
Fire.
Safe to say, I don't think this cage is going to hold as long as we hope it would be, because these two would gladly rip the panels off and just beat each other with it to death.
Bye, boys.
Well, either way, this is your opening bout of Live 46, Number of the Beast. And here we go.
Yeah, we're off.
Oh!
Of course he would. Of course he would. Duncan, like we always say, Duncan is Duncan. He'll do whatever he damn well pleases.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Damn it, I want to make a joke for what I've heard over in the world of professional wrestling through many, many social media outlets.
Right now, either way, first, Duncan going to town on Darren Payne, but oh god.
Yeah, remember, the only way to win this matchup is Payne.
Jesus, stalling suplex.
The power of the Blood Wolf.
Right now.
Oh, God. Well, it was going to happen sooner or later!
Oh, God!
Long dart!
And again, just like at Revolution 5... And again, just like at Revolution 5, we are seeing Duncan get manhandled by Darren Payne.
Yeah, but this is a much more angry Darren Payne. This is a much more red-eyed Darren Payne, who's looking at nothing more than to maul Duncan. If that's even possible.
Oh my.
Jesus Christ!
Let's not forget what Duncan did to people like Vin Taylor, to people like Rex Teitus, to people like Raven Dark. This man Duncan Vermil is a bona fide psychopath.
I mean, the fact that he did what he did to Vin fucking Taylor, of all people,
not
alone of how much this dude could do for violence. And speaking of...
And right now, this man who is known for intense violence, who is known to be a monster, is being out-violenced and out-monstered by the Blood Wolf here. Well, speak too soon.
I think
we're about to get a receipt!
Oh, my God!
And here's the thing about Darren Payne.
This shows pain and pain.
And here's the thing about Darren Payne. He's also one of the guys in this company who's told straight up that sooner or later he will be holding the TPGW Heavyweight Championship over the world.
Oh!
It's just not a matter of if, but when.
And this is bad.
Yeah, it's gonna. Can Bill the ring be able to handle this?
Please tell me the ring has been reinforced.
It has.
Good.
Because if they have these two on top of that, I don't know.
Honestly, if the ring breaks and all those panels fall, there it is.
Oh!
Then again, they could just use them as weapons.
Oh my God.
Ow!
Duncan German suplex.
God.
I feel bad for the referee just outside the door.
This is a vicious hoss fight between two bitter rivals that isn't going to stop until one of them is either bloody, broken, or just straight up dead.
All three.
Oh, well, yeah.
Oh, God. And his, like I said,
Oh boy.
Heads up!
Oh, my chokeslam.
Oh, yeah.
The power of Duncan Vermil lifting up Darren Payne, who's probably 6'9", 6'10", pushing almost 300 pounds of grade A prime beef like it was nothing. And once again, telling him what he thinks.
One last exclamation point from the Nightmare, and the Demon Horns is going to seal this.
Not all of it.
Landed. What's that? Cover. Two. No. Only a two count off the Demon Horns.
That shouldn't surprise me.
No, because as we all remember at Revolution 5, Payne took a beating from Duncan and took a lot more than took a lot of Demon Horns just for him to stay down.
The way I remember it, Payne gave the beating and Duncan, you could say, survived. Now in this steel cage match, there is no escape, so Duncan's thinking of something nasty.
Yeah, but he's not gonna be up there alone. Oh God!
You can't win this match by escaping the cage. We're not the Fed. We're not that much immense.
We're not pansies. We go old school. Oh God!
And again, what does it stop? One of the 40-yard off to the grenade.
Then you got to get your ass back in there. We ain't stopping it.
Like that? Oh my God!
Now what the hell? Now
well, get the pansies. It's even worse.
Oh no! Oh God! Oh God! Oh,
Duncan. Gee, oh no!
Nothing but canvas after a 15-foot drop! I think I heard a big
splash. Oh, in hell, man. Landed.
That was nasty.
Yeah. You can say that again, man. Okay. Oh,
no. Okay.
Whoa! Oh!
Jump line!
Cope, clutch,
ah, damn. Move it. Darren Payne's what I think he's not doing.
Drop a Payne!
Oh, Gene.
Drop a Payne!
Got it!
Stick it!
The drop of Payne, will that be the end of Duncan Vermil?
I think Darren wants to finish him off. He's going for, I think he calls it the bloodshot.
No, the boot of, good night!
The boot of Payne. Is what he calls
good
it.
Good night. That might have probably not.
One, two,
three.
What?
Duncan is Duncan.
Yeah, I'm gonna say I was like, stitch.
Don't do it. Duncan, Darren gave him both the drop of pain and the boot of pain, and he still kicked out.
Oh.
Duncan Vermil, and like you always say, Duncan is fucking Duncan.
Duncan Vermil took 100 German suplexes, got up, and won the match.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, who could ever forget that one?
But oh god, look at Darren Payne here. Oh dear, oh dear.
Oh god.
Oh god!
Remember, this is a steel mesh. This is solid iron bars.
Look at Darren Payne. Look at the look of ferocity on his face. Oh god!
He is in,
if he wasn't already pissed.
He is in blood wrath mode.
Oh, that ain't good.
Oh my god!
How many times have you been logged out into that?
That's, now he's going for four.
Oh!
That's four to the head.
I've never seen Duncan take this kind of brutality.
Oh, how about five?
Oh my god. This is getting uncomfortable to watch.
Well, that's the first time anyone's ever said that about a duck game on people.
Oh my god.
Oh, Jesus Christ. And now he's going to finish it off again. Uda Payne,
loaded!
Jesus!
I think I saw his head go to the cheap seats.
One, two. Oh my god.
Uda Payne gets his revenge.
What the fuck?
Takes out Duncan Vermil.
What the fuck?
You don't hear this often in TPGW, but somebody has become the man to out-monster Duncan fucking Vermil.
What the fuck?
He gave him six lawn darts to the cage, and then finished him off with a boot of doom. I think I saw his soul go to the cheap seats. Oh god. Be afraid, because the blood...
Yeah, I'll be very afraid.
And he might be looking at our next world champion. Oh god.
Cancer!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're back after that vicious beating Duncan Vermil received at the hands of Darren Payne. Doctors aren't even sure. Duncan's not even conscious right now.
Thanks to say, that rivalry between the Blood Wolf and Duncan Vermil is not over by a mile.
Indeed, but I've never seen Duncan in that condition before. And oh boy, but nonetheless, we have the Tartarus Championship on the line, and look who's here to compete for it.
Indeed. The Tartarus Championship, brand new to the Queens of Wrestling stable. It is basically their version of the Hell's Gambit Championship over at VWU. Now first. Okay, get ring addictions.
Jacob,
I'm white winner.
Yeah, I was going to say, why don't you tell us a little bit about this competitor?
Adeline White winner, one of the members of the Cortez family. She hails from White Run in the world realm of Skyrim. She's the current UWL Solar Flare champion after shocking the world and taking the belt off of Morgan Raincroft back at Ashes of Eden over at UWL. She would love to capture the Tartarus Championship for the first time.
And who do we have now? Wait a minute.
Oh. Wait! That's AJ Mendez! Wife of current AEW superstar CM Punk. Former longest reigning Divas champion. I can't believe I actually said that.
You say what you want. She's the only one who ever put respect on that.
That's the truth. But yeah, nonetheless, AJ Mendez, one of the leaders of the anti-diva revolution in the Fed, now a part of TPGW, and hopefully might be getting a shot to become Tartarus champion here in Queens of here tonight.
Now, clarify. She is a special guest challenger for the Queens of Wrestling Tartarus Championship. She is not in TPGW. But if she wins this match, I certainly might consider that. If she I know she's also a very busy person.
It's true, she is, of course.
But nonetheless, here comes the Tartarus champion, the dominatrix, Jennifer Gruel.
Inaugural Tartarus champion, won the belt back at Prestige 4, beating Captain Marvel in a steel cage match. It was known, I think it was a Lioness Den match, if I remember correctly. Or I could be wrong.
It wasn't, but maybe it could be in the future. We don't know.
Nonetheless, like I said, Jennifer Gruel getting an ultimate good bounce back after dealing with the certain witch, Sanaya Enix. Now the current Tartarus champion would love to not go one and done here tonight in her first defense.
Indeed, and we will see soon whether or not Jennifer can actually hold up to that. But I've just received word from the back that this will also be, that apparently the winner of this is from Holly Harris, the winner of this, if it's not Jennifer, will receive a TPGW contract and will challenge Tony Storm for the Diamonds World title at Resurrection.
And from what it looks of it, the Queens of Wrestling board has decreed this match will be a tables, ladders, and chairs match for the Tartarus Championship.
Indeed, first person to climb the ladder and retrieve the belt will be Queens of Wrestling Tartarus Champion, but also will challenge Tony Storm for the Diamonds World Championship at TPGW Resurrection. Coming soon, I promise.
Indeed. It'll happen. But anyway, this is going to be a brutal matchup, to say the least. Three women have their own reasons of wanting the Tartarus Championship. Two of them because they want to get a contract with TPGW, but for Jennifer Gruel, she wants to not go one and done and have the French benefit of possibly going out to the Diamonds World title, becoming a three-time Diamonds World Champion.
That's correct, but let's not forget, it's also about the opportunity for Jennifer to get a little payback on Tony Storm and also to send a little message to someone who also wants a shot at Tony Storm. If you remember Christmas in the Garden. Well, look at this, AJ. AJ's up there.
AJ's got 3-day, but Adelaide with the block there. And she met, yeah, oh, this ain't gonna be pretty. Ah, electric chair.
You have to think, AJ also hasn't competed that much in the past few years, so.
Yeah, she has some ring rust on her. She hasn't been in the ring in a good long while. Even though she is, of course, a part of Women's Wrestling as well.
Oh, God, oh, God, oh, God. Oh, my God.
Oh, there's a chair.
We have chairs now.
Yeah, it's not a TLC match without chairs.
You're sweet, good God. Jennifer just completely and utterly decimated Adeline right there. Well, she's called the Dominatrix for a reason, and now on the table, no! Oh, God!
Oh, AJ! Oh, nice clothesline!
AJ didn't want to get dropped again after getting dropped off that ladder.
Indeed, of course, that was one of the main reasons why she had to retire professional wrestling all those years ago. And other things.
Indeed. Mendez with a kick to the gut, but nonetheless, reversal. Now Adeline sending AJ into the ropes. But wait a minute, Jennifer's got the ladder.
And Adeline
says nope and hits AJ at the exact same time.
Indeed.
Now we have a table involved. Oh, God.
Oh, now we got the full set. Oh, nice block from the chair from Adeline. Of course, as I stated, Adeline White Winter, one of the many lovers of the Cortez family. She is the youngest of the White Winter family, but she has shown that she may be the smallest.
Oh, no.
Oh,
my God.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph, the jerk. Suplex onto the ladder. Now, AJ throwing out.
Oh, no.
Adeline to the ropes here.
Neckbreaker.
Assistant. On the table. That was on the edge of the table.
Adeline is just getting all the punishment in this match.
But remember, she is a member of White Run, so she knows how to take punishment. I mean, for fuck's sake, when she was a young child, she was given a knife by her parents to say, go hunt a bear.
Yes, that's right. A mad scramble for the ladder on the outside, and
yeah, all three women were just so into trying to get that championship that they just basically went crazy, you know.
Indeed, and now, oh, AJ with a mean right hook to Jennifer Poole.
Indeed, that was a mean hook. Now, AJ now with the nice block there from Jennifer Cruel. Jennifer now, got her in a hammer lock.
AJ fighting out of it though.
Mm-hmm. And these multi-person matchups is just madness from the start.
Indeed. And, oh no, what's AJ looking for? Oh, correction, what's Adeline looking for?
Well, Adeline, whatever she damn well pleases. What is this?
That is a tree of woe.
Oh, yeah.
That is... No. Oh, no, tree of woe. Oh, God! My God!
Mushroom stomp!
Absolutely vicious.
Oh, God. And now Jennifer just been going to town with that ladder.
And Jennifer, she's trying to set up the ladder in a proper position.
But it is tricky to try to get in the right position when you have the belt constantly moving back and forth, you know. Adeline gets back to her feet, took enough time.
Jennifer reversing. Oh, tornado DDT.
It's just tornado DDT there. Now AJ wants to get a piece in. There with a gun stun. Should I say the stun gun? And a slam there from Mendez.
Jennifer she got to the caught. Outside. This crowd on their feet for this match, and whoa!
Oh, Jennifer gets right back into the swing of things. Takes out both White Winter and Mendez. Now just going to town with those knee strikes to the side of the head.
Indeed, and that, oh boy, we got a table. We got another, a table.
Another table.
Where'd that broken table come from?
I don't know. He's just staying there just to survey the damage.
I think I saw Landkrieg come through with some table parts.
Landkrieg, never change.
But nonetheless, here comes Jennifer Krull.
Jennifer now going after him. Going after Mendez!
Oh!
Ah, the shiningest of wizards. No offense to Tegan Knox.
Now the Irish whip to the outside.
Now it looks like Jennifer might have an opening here.
Oh, she's going up. Yeah. She's going up. She's got it.
She's got an opening here. She's got an opening. I think she's got it.
And Jennifer Krull retains.
And with this win at TPGW Resurrection, she will challenge Toni Storm for the Diamonds World Championship. She has a chance to become a three-time Diamonds World Champion with this win here tonight. You have to give AJ, Edge, and Adelaide a lot of credit. They put up a good fight, but at the end of the day, it's still the Dominatrix world to bear.
Indeed, the question is, will anyone be able to take that belt off Jennifer, and will Toni Storm be able to stop Jennifer now that she's got the momentum on her side?
Indeed. Congratulations to Jennifer Krull on retaining the Queens of Wrestling Tartarus Championship and punching her ticket to Resurrection.
Jeremiah was stabbed in the AWF locker room. Detective Black Oak, we must interrogate the suspects, find our man.
Let's find that.
Now, where were you at the time of the stabbing?
I've just woke up and suddenly I'm here. And where I was? I don't know. I was high. You tell me.
I was in Vegas, having probably the best orgy you've ever had in your life.
Really? You think I did it? Man, go tech yourself.
Hey, what kind of name is John Black Oak? The fuck?
It wasn't me. And anything, I was with AJ, right AJ?
Officer, Jay was not with me. I've never seen or heard of that man a day in my life.
You fucking bitch, you can't do this one thing for me. Really, AJ?
Oh, here we go. Officer, take him away.
I was looking at anime titties. They call me the anime titty king.
I'ma hold on to that for research purposes.
Fucking weebs, right next.
Hell yeah, I did that shit. Bitch threw a vegetable at me. So we got a knife thrown at his fucking esophagus.
Well, I hate JMI, so we'll just call it self-defense.
Get out, you smoothie drinking, vegetable throwing bitch! We're trying to watch some AWF. Jeez, man.
We'll be right back.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're back, and it's main event time.
Oh, and it's good, and it's a big one here tonight for Live 46.
Indeed, a no disqualification tag team tornado match.
Out first is the assassin, Andrew Tanaka.
Andrew Tanaka will be taking on Soul Reaper at TPGW Resurrections in a similar no-holds-barred environment.
Indeed. And you gotta believe Soul Reaper has gotta be a little concerned because of what happened, not only here in TPGW, but over in Project Mania when he's been running roughshod, driving the owner, Mr. Rose, to the point where he actually jumped him. Which put the very fate of Project Mania at risk because of the unclause Soul Reaper put on Mr. Rose, if you remember.
Indeed. But more importantly, it's going to be about Andrew Tanaka tonight and whether or not he can get some momentum against the Sex God of Destruction. But he's got a great partner to do it with.
Indeed.
The assassin, Patrick Wolf.
Yeah, it is the battle of the team of the assassins versus two men who basically have no love lost for either for any of these men, and their partners. As we know, Andrew Tanaka wants a piece of Soul Reaper, but Patrick Wolf has got his own problems to deal with here in the People's Global Wrestling. Case in point, the one returning, Vincent Cipriani, which he is going to be facing here tonight.
And he'll be facing at Resurrection.
Yeah, all four of these men want momentum as we get closer and closer to Resurrection, live on Click Per View. Anyway, we have team number one all set up and ready to go. Let's get team number two out here. First, the former TPGW World Heavyweight Champion and the so-called final boss in Vincent Cipriani.
Vincent Cipriani, or some people like to call him in certain circles, Cannoli, coming down to the ring right now.
Like I said, former TPGW World Heavyweight Champion, TPGW Triple Crown winner, former TPGW Euro American Champion. He's basically almost won every championship here in the People's Global Wrestling.
He's not a former Euro American Champion. He's a former World Champion and a former Tag Team Champion.
Okay. I must have got my notes mixed up. My apologies.
No, he's facing a former Euro American Champion in Patrick Wolf, as well as Soul Reaper, who's a former Euro American champion.
Okay. Thank you. Anyway, nonetheless, he made his mission ever since getting humiliated back at Revolution 5 to end the career of Patrick Wolf by any means necessary, even if it means bringing back Vincent.
Indeed, but let's not forget that Vincent Cipriani's vendetta isn't just with Patrick Wolf, but it's the legacy that Patrick Wolf represents.
Indeed, and that legacy represents one man and one man only, and that is Mr. Matt Farrell, who unfortunately might have had his retirement tour come to a head early, thanks to Vincent. Anyway, here comes
more
his
like
tag team partner.
More like thanks to Zach Stone, but.
Yeah, Zach Stone finished the job, but Vincent started it. And you can already hear the beats going through the arena here in live as closer plays out as we are being joined by the Sex God of Destruction.
Indeed. the former two-time TPGW World Champion, the longest consecutive reigning TPGW World Champion.
Indeed.
And of course, the sex god of destruction.
He's also the current UWL Gift of Talos champion is, of course, Mr. Soul Reaper.
Of all the people that represent TPGW in the past, there is no one that represents TPGW as much as Reaper. Someone who has main evented Revolution twice.
Yes.
And in one of those main events, in the very first one, he became TPGW World Champion. Back when it was the TPWF Championship. But nonetheless, tonight is about Reaper's vendetta against Andrew Tanaka, who cost him.
Indeed.
Who attacked him during the TPGW World Title Triple Threat main event at Revolution 5.
Indeed, costing him the world title, which is now being held by, of course, Son Gohan.
It'll be interesting to see how Reaper handles this situation here tonight.
Considering the fact that he's teaming with a partner he doesn't want to be within two throne stills of, and against one of his opponents at Resurrection. As this, our main event of Live 46 is underway. It is a tornado tag team match between Andrew Tanaka and Patrick Wolf, and the Sex God of Destruction, Soul Reaper, and Vincent Cipriani.
Indeed, and oh! Cipriani with a shot to the back of Patrick Wolf. Look out, gentleman's clutch, suplex, no!
Oh, on that one.
Oh, God, do you hear that chop in the corner? Reaper is absolutely giving no mercy in the slice to Andrew Tanaka.
Oh, indeed, he wants to weaken Andrew Tanaka before their match at TPGW Resurrection.
And look at that, Reaper and Vincent don't exactly have a positive history with each other. But right now, Reaper, if anything, does not want to lose. And what in the blue hell is Reaper doing to Wolf? Oh my God!
Ow! 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 Good God in heaven, those headbutts!
Right now, the two men in the ring, where you can, is the only place you can get a pinfall, by the way, or submission, are Andrew Tanaka and Vincent Cipriani. Oh! Did you see that?
Oh my
kick?
Jesus Christ!
What we have on here is nothing but a brawl between four individuals who absolutely despise each other.
Yeah, who have no love lost for neither their partners nor their opponents. Yeah. That's what it is.
Oh. If anything, we're getting a resurrection preview here tonight. It's just how chaotic each of these individual matchups are going to be.
Basically, this. Oh, nice. Now it looks like Wolf and Tanaka are getting the advantage here. Got Vincent on the outside, and now working on Soul Reaper here.
Oh my God! Shot to the arm from Wolf, and look out! Vincent's back in the ring. Fireman's carry.
It's Fireman's carry there.
I think Vincent was trying to low blow. No.
Oh jeez, burning hair!
And now the assassin lock to Soul Reaper. Right now, Tanaka and Wolf are in complete control.
Oh, charging flatline of it there from Andrew Tanaka.
It looks like they've decided to trade partners, but Patrick Wolf is the one getting the worst of it against Vincent. And oh my goodness gracious!
Yeah, we're now getting a resurrection preview here. As all four men go after their respective opponents.
Now, oh God, Reaper. Oh my God, just destroying the legs of Tanaka. That's going to hurt some of Tanaka's offense. He is a striker, after all.
Yes, he is. You take out the legs, you take out a lot of the strikes in Tanaka's wet arsenal, including the power game as well.
And he needs that power game if he wants to hit that burning hammer. And oh my God.
Now he's just going to work on Soul Reaper here.
And let's not forget, no disqualifications. Patrick Wolf bringing in the tables.
Yeah, we got the woodwork in here.
And I think he's regretting that side effect into the corner of the table. Jesus.
Yeah, that was a wicked side effect there from Soul Reaper. And now it's back to 2-on-1 for Vincent and Soul Reaper here.
Oh, and a chop block just as Patrick Wolf had taken down Vincent Cipriani. Yeah. Except now Andrew Tanaka's back in.
Got another. Yeah, Tanaka's back in the match.
Ooh, massive axe kick.
A beautiful axe kick there.
And now look at this. Patrick Wolf, I think he's looking to play ball.
Yeah, he is. He's got a baseball bat here.
Oh,
oh, oh. Oh, right to the gut. There it is. G down.
And V got popped right in the top of the head. See what I did there?
Yeah, more plays than one cover here, but Soul Reaper breaks it up. Yeah, it feels like Patrick Wolf was having a little bit of batting practice, much like Insert Sports Team here.
Well, we are in Chicago.
Fair enough. Maybe you could actually do better for the Cubbies.
Ooh.
Anyway, Wolf.
Tanaka with the stomp.
Only a two count. Vincent had to kick him out personally because Soul Reaper was just a little bit too late.
Oh, there's the scythe.
There it is, the scythe. And vicious cutter that Soul Reaper has perfected in his time here in virtual wrestling.
Look out, neckbreaker to Patrick Wolf.
That is one of the big moves Andrew Tanaka's got to worry about for their match at Resurrection. And also, Soul Reaper's infamous punt kick, otherwise known as Welcome to Primetime, bitch. Now it looks like we're back into the 2-on-1 situation for both Reaper and Cipriani.
Oh my, what in the world?
Cipriani getting the cover on Tanaka. Wolf!
But did you see that? Did you see that frog splash cross body combo? Whoa. Assassin lock.
Oh, another assassin lock here from Wolf, from Tanaka, and this time by Wolf onto Vincent. He would love to make Vincent tap before the match at Resurrection, but Soul Reaper breaks that up easily.
Again, it is surprising how well Vincent and Reaper are working well together in this match.
You have to believe that as soon as this match is over, either one is gonna throw the knife to their back. You know it's gonna happen. Okay? But that's how egotistical both men are. They want to take the glory for themselves, you know?
Look out, here comes Reaper! Oh!
Reaper! Ah! Knee right to the back of the head.
Oh, but there's the Fang suplex.
Indeed. Over here, two. Only a two count.
Now, oh boy. This is a bad 2-on-1 situation for Patrick Wolf.
Yeah, he is literally in between a rock and a hard place.
But Patrick Wolf trying to fight his way back into this.
Patrick's back up on his feet here.
And now suddenly the situation's reversed. And old Vincent's going to be the one. Old Vincent, I should say, is the one who's going to get the punishment. Or at least I thought he was going to.
Burning hammer! Burning hammer! Wait a minute! Reaper was a little late on it. Or was he?
Unholy Grace!
Oh, Unholy Grace.
I'm sorry, that was the Unholy Driver. My apologies. But nonetheless, this one's over.
But it was... But call what you will, call it effective. Soul Reaper gets the pinfall over Andrew Tanaka and gets the much-needed win heading to Resurrection. They have to say, when these four men rock up at Resurrection for their respective singles matches, expect the rules to be thrown out the window.
Indeed, we only have one more stop, and that's TPGW Fury. It certainly is going to be interesting to see how.
And then after Fury, it's no stops, no sleep till we head to Resurrection.
Whoa!
See what I mean? I told you! I told you! They don't trust either one of them, and Reaper decided if he's not going to do it, I'll do it myself.
What is going to happen at Resurrection? That is the million-dollar question. Soul Reaper, the one standing tall in a sea of bodies, is how we end TPGW Live 46. For Robert McNicol, I'm mtbDAhkk, and we will see you next time.
See you guys next time.